We all love stories because they engage us in some sort of journey. But these stories aren't always fictional. In fact, the stories that we watch through documentaries happen to have a greater impact on us as they are part of our reality. True stories that inspire us to live with a new perspective. Now, let's see which documentaries have told better stories this year. American Factory. It's the story of a Chinese billionaire who traveled to Ohio, America to build a factory in the husk of an abandoned General Motors plant. It reveals the real interaction between high-tech China and 2,000 blue-collar Americans. The Edge of Democracy, a tale that explores one of the most dramatic periods in Brazilian history. The film showcases the story of two Brazilian presidents, Lula da Silva and Dilma Rousseff, along with the incidents that follow in terms of democracy in a polarized nation.
But something in our social fabric started to change. The country divided into two parts. And this wall. Would rip us apart.
Sama.
For Sama, the story of a Syrian mother and all the obstacles she goes through during the 5 years of war in the country, and her love story that gives birth to her daughter Sama. The film shows us how the life of a mother looks like in the time of war and how this leads her to the dilemma of leaving or staying in her homeland. Honeyland, the story of a girl in an isolated mountain region deep within the Balkans, living with her mother in a village dealing with the shortage of roads, electricity, or running water. It reveals the obstacles of wild beekeeping and how a rival beekeeper breaks the harmony of nature around them in his hunt for profit. Becoming, an inspiring story of Michelle Obama and an up-close look at her life and how she travels along a 34-city tour to reunite people by the power of connection that comes through an honest sharing of personal stories. Some good times.
She's just a girl and she's on fire. So little of who I am happened in those 8 years. So much more of who I was happened before.
In high school, your guidance counselor didn't see in you what you saw in yourself. Yeah.
She decided I was reaching too high.
I wanted to be part of the world, but I didn't see anyone like me in it.
I hear about a summer camp for the handicapped run by hippies. Somebody said you probably will smoke dope with the counselors, and I'm like, sign me up.
Crip Camp, a disability revolution. The story of the camp Janet in the early 1970s, a utopian place with summertime sports, smoking, and make-out sessions for the disabled people to feel fulfilled as human beings, where their bond and friendship led them to a forum of unity to run a movement for disability rights.
The world always wants us dead. We live with that reality.
Mr. President, is it important that people be afraid of you? Fear. Yes.
A Thousand Cuts, a film that walks you through the dangerous life of the journalist Maria Ressa, as opposed to the authoritarian regime of Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte, the man who hid his activities behind the diffusion of disinformation through social media.
President Duterte began his administration with the drug list.
This is the drug industry of the Philippines.
He showed everyone a list. People on that list started dying.
I'm telling the Filipino people it's gonna be bloody.
We demanded the government be held accountable.
Duterte was annoyed by our reporting.
You are a fake news outlet. They will be allowed to criticize us, but you go to jail for your crime.
During my first semester at MIT, I got computer vision software that was supposed to track my face. It didn't work until I put on this white mask. I'm thinking, all right, what's going on here? Is it the lighting conditions? Is it the angle at which I'm looking at the camera? Or is there something more?
Coded bias. The story of injustice through the perspective of an MIT Media Lab researcher who investigates the reasons for face recognition malfunction for the people of color. It reveals the roots of systemic bias in an artificial device meant to be neutral.
Everybody has unconscious biases, and people embed their own biases into technology.
A biosphere is a closed system with plants and animals and the atmospheres all inside. We called it Biosphere 2 because Biosphere 1 is the Earth.
Spaceship Earth. A film that projects the adventure of 8 explorers who spend 2 years quarantined inside of a self-engineered replica of Earth ecosystem called Biosphere 2 in 1991. It goes through the obstacles of life for these people as the cost of an experiment to create a new world.
I don't know any innovative human organization that doesn't have cult-like aspects.
Learning to skateboard in a war zone, if you're a girl. The story of bringing joy and hope for the girls in the war zone of Afghanistan, where children are deprived of their rights to live in peace and having the proper education to build their future. These were the brilliant true stories of 2020 told by the documentary filmmakers. But life goes on, and every day there is a new story to film, and the new filmmaker who wants to change our perspective.